Hey guys, so today I got the 350 down here, and we're gonna be hooking up to my Massey 12 baler. I'm gonna bring it up closer to my little work area. I need to do some welding on it. As you can see, that is where the guides stay in this groove in here. They stay in this groove and they ride around and they keep the tines straight. And last year we tried, but I had two bad, actually they were completely missing. The pickup needles didn't pick up anything at all, and it just turned into a big cluster, and I just abandoned ship, really. So like I said, I tried last year, but the pickup needles, they would just flop over. So we discovered I have to take these guides. They have three holes where the where your pickup tines are, and they bolt into, I'll show you guys, it's hard to explain, and that's essentially what keeps them straight and just keep picking up as they, instead of rolling over whenever they hit the ground or the hay. But I'm gonna do some welding repair on it today. If I can dodge the rain, I will. If not, then it might have to wait for another day. We have a tractor pull coming up on Saturday at Cookport. So we're probably gonna take the 350. Just being the guy that I am, you know, I say straight pipes save lives. So I had to put one on it just to see if I'd like it or not, and I think I'll keep it on for the pulls. Laurel pulls it, I don't. So if she says it's too loud and she says I don't want it anymore, then that's fine. I don't mind the muffler. I don't actually mind the muffler on it. And then hopefully we'll be getting the 60 out to a pull soon. We get the 60 out. We got to get the sickle bar hooked up on the C. I got to get a new... I gotta get a PTO shaft for the brush hog so I can do that. So it's starting to sprinkle now. I better get it done before it starts raining. So today, it's getting a little bit later. Got home from work. I drove the Super C down to the field here and put the boom pole on the 350. And I'm gonna try. I already got the bottom bolts on the sickle bar mower for our Super C. It's getting, is it May? It's early May. And, you know, June is just around the corner. As you can see, the field, it's getting there. It's definitely springtime around here. I'm not gonna mess around today. So I want to get this picked up because I tried to pick it up by hand and I'm just, there's not two of me or three of me. So I'm going to pick it up with the boom pole on the 350, get it bolted into place, put the PTO on, lay it down, grease it out, check it out because we haven't used this. This mower is new to us. And maybe later this week, along and we'll mow a test pass with it. See if we need any sickle sections or anything like that. So I'm gonna get to it. So this is the final product here, guys. I was running out of time the other day hooking this up. I had to fight these four bolts right here. I fought them and fought them because obviously the mower, it's obviously heavier on that side. So I had more of a time fighting this side here to get on. And then I also hooked up the hydraulics to it to pick it up and lower it. And I also got the PTO on. So I used it already, and that will be coming in a later video. So thanks for watching.